Hello, everybody. I'm Jeff Phillips, and welcome to Webisode Wednesday. Each week, we bring in a new business or organization to tell us a little bit more about themselves. And today, I'm happy to have Susan Henson. Welcome.
Hello.
And why don't you tell everybody a little bit about yourself and what it is that you do?
Great. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I'm Susan Henson. I'm the founder of Pharaoh's Daughter, which is a nonprofit prison ministry that serves the women who are incarcerated and pregnant in the state of North Carolina. And we start by taking care of the babies that are born to women in prison. We visit their moms every week. We then mentor the moms once they are released so that we're turning back into our communities intact family units that are gainfully employed and have suitable housing.
Okay, so let's get kind of right into some questions that I have for you. First one is, how many pregnant and incarcerated women are there in North Carolina?
That's a good question. It's a little bit of a moving target, but the records show that 60 plus on any given day, women are pregnant and incarcerated down in our Raleigh facility. And they are from across the state. They're also at different levels of incarceration. You might have minimum, medium, or maximum security women. They're all housed in our one and only medium maximum facility due to the medical facility that's there. So they are held there all together through the pregnancy, the birth of their child, and also through postpartum.
All right, so this brings me to the second question is, how many babies are actually born in this plight each year?
Okay, that's a great question too. So as of last year, they documented that there were 78 women who had babies while incarcerated in this state. There was one set of twins born, so that's a total of 79 babies that were born in the state of North Carolina. Their mothers were incarcerated.
Okay. And then what happens to these babies who were born under these circumstances?
Well, currently in the state of North Carolina, these women have two choices. They can either send their baby to a relative, and oftentimes that is not a safe or stable place for a baby to be. Now, it might be due to alcohol or substance abuse, could be just the types of people that are coming in and out of the home where the child will be, or it could be due to the age or health or finances of that relative. Now, their second option is sort of the obvious. People always ask, well, what about foster care? So that is certainly another option, but this mother would give over her parental rights to social services, then that baby would be placed in a foster family, a foster home, and that presents some problems in and of itself. So if the mother is incarcerated for longer than 12 months, that child can be adopted out without the mother's consent. Wow. The other thing is that once she is released, sometimes it's very difficult to get your child out of the system. So it could be weeks to years before this mother can actually get her child back. And so another reason is that visitation doesn't occur, which means the bond between the mother and the child will be broken. And that's really important.
Okay. This is all new news to me. And, you know, thank you for educating me on that. And I don't know about the viewers out there, but if they wanted to get involved and help out with this cause, what can they do?
Oh, I would love it. It's going to take an army to really do this. If you will follow after this, the website, people can go to the website and there's a place where you can sign up for a newsletter to kind of keep up with us. We have a Facebook page. There is a place there that you can donate money if that's your gig, or we need baby holders and everything in between.
Okay. So you're actually looking for people for these babies to stay with?
No, they all stay with me. Oh. But I do need anything from overnight care to just some relief in the daytime. There are errands to be run, groceries to be gotten, things like that. So if people want to run errands for us, or if they want to come and hold babies, it's a lot of fun.
Wow. Wow. You got your hands full,
yeah,
literally speaking.
I do. So. I do.
Well, very good. Well, thank you very much,
Susan.
Well,
thanks for having me.
Yeah. And if any of you are, like Susan said, interested in finding out more, please check out the website at the end of this video. Other than that, have a great one, and we'll see you next time.